Atlantis ISS, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
We're ready.
WBNG-TV, this is Houston. Please call Atlantis ISS for a voice check.
Atlantis ISS, this is WBNG-TV. How do you hear me?
The ISS has you loud and clear. How us?
Good afternoon, Atlantis. You know, the launch was a success. The docking was just so emotional for everyone here. How has this mission been so far?
I got one word for you, really busy. we've had a great time. We've got some great station hosts up here, and we're just trying to get them all stocked up for the next year.
When you're up there, is it all work and no play, or do you get some downtime to enjoy yourselves on this final mission?
Well, we haven't had much downtime yet, but we're working really hard to try and get ahead a bit. So when we get our half day off, we can actually take the day off and look out the window. The views from the cupola are truly spectacular, and that's probably where you'll find us on flight day 8 when we have our time off.
Are there any mementos that you plan to take home from this final mission?
Well, I think we plan to bring more up than we do to bring back. Most of the things that are up here on station we're bringing up for a reason, and they need them. But we all bring some personal mementos on each shuttle flight, and we have them as souvenirs and for folks who have really worked hard for us throughout the years.
This next question is for pilot Doug Hurleyâ. We are here in the southern tier of New York. You're a Tioga County native, graduate of Owego Free Academy. What does this area in the southern tier of New York mean to you?
Well, it's my hometown. It'll always be my home. I get back there whenever I can, and just like to say hi to everybody back there.
You know, this crew, you're really an inspiration to everywhere across the United States, but especially kids. What advice do you have for kids wanting to get into NASA and get in the field?
Well, I think our advice would be just to work really hard in school, especially in science and math, because that's very, very important in this business. And then keep after your dreams. You never know. I dreamed of becoming an astronaut a long time ago. I never really thought it was possible, but I kept after it, and sure enough, we were able to. And I think a lot of us have those stories. It just takes a lot of persistence, a lot of hard work.
So I've been listening over the last couple of days, and I really enjoy those morning songs with the wake-up call. Where do these come from, and how do you choose? I mean, you had Chumbawamba, you had Elton John, you had Coldplay. Tell me a little bit about that.
Actually, normally our families pick out, during a normal mission, our families will pick out our wake-up music for us, and some of it comes as a little bit of a surprise. This mission's a little special in that NASA arranged for several surprise wake-up songs from various different artists, and we're still waiting to hear what the rest of them are, but it's been really fun, you know, to wake up every morning to a different song, and it sort of sets the mood for the day.
What do you plan to do when you get back? I know it's a couple days away and you're focused on your mission there right now, but any plans for when you actually touch ground here at home? What's the first things you want to do?
Well, I think all of us will probably savor the moment for a few minutes maybe, and then I think all of us are really looking forward to getting outside and kind of sharing it with all the great folks at Kennedy Space Center, and then a few hours later getting to see our family and friends. I think that's really what it's all about.
Mr. Hurleyâ, this question is again for you. You're the last pilot to shuttle these missions. What are your plans? Where do you go from here?
Well, my first priority is obviously to be to complete this mission successfully and help out everybody here on the ISS and my crewmates. And then once we get back on the ground, spend a little time with family and friends. And then from there, you know, we'll be working on the next vehicle for NASA. We're going to help out our commercial partners. So there's a lot to look forward to. There's a bright future in spaceflight.
So far, this final mission has been nothing but a success. Do you see the last 30 years of NASA being just that, a success?
Yeah, I'll tell you, it's a fantastic world up here. And if I could convey one message to you, it would be when you stand poised about 600 feet underneath the International Space Station and look up and see that grand thing pass over you, it is really spectacular. You know, NASA's past 30 years of space shuttle, you know, when it's all done, we have the space station to show for it. We have tremendous observatories in space. It's been a great program.
Atlantis ISS, thank you so much from WBNG. Thank you from everyone in the Southern Tier. Keep up the great work, and good luck with the rest of the mission.
We'll see you later.
Atlantis ISS, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the WBNG-TV portion of the event. Please stand by for a voice check from WICZ-TV.
Hello, how do you hear me?
This is the International Space Station. We have you loud and clear.
Hi, thanks so much. How you guys doing?
We're doing fine. How's it going down there in Binghamton?
It's doing pretty well. Not too cloudy for once. Well, first up, I have a question. I have a few questions from some people in the area, and then I have my questions here. First off, I want to know, and this is for everyone, you know, the four of you, how does it feel to be part of history, you know, being one of the few people to venture off into a space shuttle, you know?
You know, we kind of don't think about it like that. This is sort of our normal job, and occasionally you just have to stop. And I remember when I lived here on the space station, I got so much into the work and getting things done. Every now and then I had to stop and think about where I was. It's like, oh, my gosh, I'm floating in a big, huge building, you know, 200 miles above the Earth, and this is really special. And so, you know, when you're doing your day-to-day job, you can't really think about it in those kinds of terms. But all of us are honored to be a part of this mission. And we're doing our best to leave the station in a good configuration when we leave.
And do you know what's next for NASA at all? Will there be anything replacing the space shuttle?
Yes, we're very hard at work on that right now. The NASA is really looking forward trying to go to the next level. We're right now the space shuttle comes here to the International Space Station and will continue to man the space station, continue to do research now that the space station is built. And beyond that, our access to space, we're going to try to get a vehicle that can go beyond low Earth orbit, and we're going to turn over some of the flights to the space station to taxi crew members back and forth to some of the commercial providers. So we're kind of trying to transition to a more commercial approach for the low Earth orbit, but for the real true exploration beyond low Earth orbit, we're trying to develop our own vehicle to do that.
Oh, wow. And this question is actually for Doug. This is from Corey out here in Binghamton, and he wants to know what inspired you to go to outer space.
Well, I think it was several things. It was, you know, college professors that got you interested in a particular subject. It was coaches that got you interested in being part of a team. It was, you know, flying fighters and then being able to be a test pilot, you know, so it was a number of different things that got me interested in. It was also a love of airplanes, so a lot of different things led me up here to the space station.
And this question is for anyone who wants to answer. This is from Eli. He's a little boy out here in Vestal, and he wants to know where you guys sleep. Do you sleep in bunks, on the floor, or do you float?
Well, we actually sleep in we just sleep floating in space. We have sleeping bags that will unroll and will usually stretch along a wall or on the ceiling, perhaps. But we'll just stretch them between two locations, pull them taut, and you climb into your sleeping bag and you sleep like that. It's very comfortable. It's a great place to sleep.
And a little girl named Mira wants to know if training is hard to be an astronaut.
You know, training is not really hard. It's a lot like being in school. You have a lot of different things to study. And then, you know, when we go on a mission, it's kind of like our open book test because we have to demonstrate that we learned everything that we're supposed to learn. But it's a lot of fun, too, because you get to learn different things every day. Just like you change different subjects in your classes at school, we change subjects all the time. So we're learning a vast array of new things, and it's fun to do that.
And Samantha wants to know, what kind of food do you guys eat up there? I know that you'll be having a big feast, you know, with the public NASA's planning. So I guess tell me what that's going to be like, and on a regular basis, what kind of food you guys will be eating.
Well, we have a lot of different kinds of food we can eat. We can have like normal stuff that's kind of like the Army would eat, just kind of heat it up and eat it. Like today I had tuna noodle casserole. We have other stuff that's dehydrated, kind of like camping food. We have some shrimp cocktail that's pretty popular around here that we like to eat, too. So we have a lot of different variety, and the food is good. It's come a long ways, and it's fun to taste different types of things we have to eat here.
And what's the first thing you guys plan to do when you come back to Earth?
Well, I think we all wouldn't mind taking a shower. Once we get back to crew quarters there at Kennedy Space Center. But, you know, our biggest thing is just to make sure that we get to share it with all the great folks down at Kennedy Space Center and thank them for their 30 years of work on this awesome space shuttle vehicle that we got to fly.
All right. Thank you guys so much. Good luck with the rest of your mission, and we're all proud of you down here.
Well, thanks a lot. And just like to say hi to all my family and friends back in Binghamton.
Atlantis ISS, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the WICZ-TV portion of the event. Please stand by for a voice check from KGO-TV.
Definitely. Roll. Atlantis ISS, this is KGO-TV. How do you hear me?
Hello, KGO-TV. This is the International Space Station. How do you copy us?
You sound fantastic. Commander Ferguson, if I could start with you, I guess today would be, the glory of being an astronaut. You get to move stuff into the International Space Station and drag the garbage out. Not the most glorious day, but the work that has to be done.
Well, I'll tell you pretty much hit the nail on the head there. That is exactly what we're doing. We have a lot of stuff we need to supply this International Space Station with to sustain them for about a year. So a lot of it's food, a lot of it's clothing, a lot of it is spare parts, and hauling out in the other direction. I wouldn't call it garbage. It's mostly broken things. It's things that need to go back to the ground. They want to take a look at it. They want to know why it failed so they can make it better the next time they send it up.
All right. Specialist Magnus, I'd like to ask you a question. How are you and how are the others from your observation reacting to this being the last shuttle mission? What are the emotions as you look about knowing that it's not going to happen again?
Well, you know, that's something we've been dealing with, the whole training flow. We've had a lot of last events, you know, last training event in the motion-based simulator, the last training event in Building 9 where our full-scale mock-ups are, the last interaction with some of the great people at Kennedy Space Center. And as we've gotten closer and closer to launch, it hit us more and more powerfully that this really was it. And I think after we get back down to the ground after landing, it's going to hit us really hard, and I think we're all going to have a really hard time leaving the shuttle and doing the walk around and greeting the people down there and just closing out the program that way. I mean, we'll be really excited that hopefully the mission went well, but we'll be very sad too because it's a great program.
Pilot Hurleyâ, a question for you, if I could. America is watching this space shuttle mission more intensely than any in years, many years. Is the historic aspect of this mission on your minds? How do you go about your day with that present?
To be real honest with you, I don't think it is. We, I think most of us, our whole lives, have been very focused and goal-oriented, and this is just one more of those things that we're doing. You know, we're so focused on the task you're doing that particular minute or that particular hour, and then, you know, task after task, and, EVA that we did yesterday and transfer that we're doing today, you know, it keeps us so focused that we tend not to, I think, look at the big picture as much. And I think we're kind of all telling ourselves that, you know, we'll have time to kind of reflect on this this whole event, this whole happening that we've gone through for the last 9 months, and hopefully be able to share it and articulate it with everybody else.
And finally, for Specialist Walheim, if I could, the local boy who made so good, I just wanted to ask you, with that last spacewalk yesterday, you're someone who has done several of those. As that was going on, last one with the shuttle, your thoughts and your emotions.
Well, it was a wonderful sight. It was a pleasure to be a part of it, and it was kind of unique for me because I've been outside on spacewalks for 5 times, but it's been about 9 years since I've been inside while the spacewalk is going on. So when those guys come right up to the window in the spacesuit, it's just a real sci-fi type of look, and it was very interesting. And it was a lot of hard work, and I was really proud of the spacewalkers. Ron Guerin and Mike Fossen, they did an awesome job, got all their tasks done, even got a bonus one done.
And another one for you, Specialist Walheim. Now that there are going to be no more shuttles to fly, what becomes of someone who was known for his flying on the shuttles? What are you going to be doing next? What's up for you?
Well, for me, I just want to continue to be involved in the program at NASA. We've got the continuing operations here on the space station. The space station is now complete. We can end the assembly phase, and now we're entering the utilization phase where we can do that groundbreaking research to find new ways to treat diseases, find out new ways to help us to be able to stay in space longer, our human body. And then we're also going to try to go beyond low Earth orbit. So I think that's really exciting, building a new system to get past the space station's altitude up to, the altitude of the moon or to an asteroid or maybe to Mars one day. And so we've got to build those systems, and I want to be involved in helping to build those.
Well, we only have maybe 20 seconds for your answer, and I hope that's fair. But I was wondering if you could say to young people who still think about going into space, we're talking about Mars, we're talking about meteors, what is it, what gives you the most excitement when you are up there or going up there? Where is that major rush?
Well, I would have to give that two things. Number one is launch. Anytime you get slung off the planet from 0 to 17,000 miles an hour in 8.5 minutes, you can't help but get an adrenaline rush, and that is absolutely spectacular. And then when you get up here, just looking back on the Earth, 220 miles down, and a couple days ago I had a chance to see California from space again, and I could see the Bay Area. It was a little bit foggy, but I could see the outline of it, and to think I was a kid down there many years ago looking up at the airplanes and dreaming of flying one day, and here I am on the International Space Station cruising along at Mach 25. It's just amazing, and if I can do it, anybody can do it. It really is. Dreams do come true with a little bit of persistence and some hard work.
All right. To all of you, thank you so much. America's watching, and look forward to seeing you back here next week.
Yeah, we appreciate that, and I just wanted to say hi to all my my friends and folks I know and my relatives in the Bay Area.
Fantastic. Thanks a lot.
Atlantis ISS, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event. Thank you all.
Thank you, WBNG-TV, WICZ-TV, and KGO-TV. Atlantis ISS, we are now resuming operational audio comms.